It's about that time of day again. Welcome back to Nightly Newsletter, boys and girls. Joseph James here. It's Monday evening, September 26, 2016. We're back to the action this evening. Hope you had a great weekend, by the way. Got an important session coming tomorrow for a Tuesday session. We got Janet Yellen's two-day testimony starting on Wednesday, which means tomorrow, Tuesday, is going to be one of the most important days of the week. It might be the last full day of trading that we get because we got to go into Yellen. Crude oil is bearish and trying to finish a move back to the battle zone. E-mini S&P is bearish and trading at a major support level. Gold is sideways and range-bound in the middle of a triangle tonight. And the euro is bullish, but showing signs that the bulls may be finished, at least in the short term. No matter how you slice it, though, we have a great newsletter in store for you guys tomorrow. We got a big day tomorrow, and I got a great strategy for you. Before we jump into our strategies, though, and start talking about these charts here, don't forget, the only place to watch the full-length version of this newsletter is here on our blog at sidewaysmarkets.com. Not to worry, if you're watching the video right now on our YouTube channel, there's a link in the description of the YouTube video. Follow that link, come over here and join me on the blog at Sideways Markets, and watch the full-length version. While you're here, though, don't forget to join the mailing list. I'll send you an email every evening before 8 p.m. Eastern time when our nightly newsletter goes live. Download all those charts for tonight's video. That's right. How easy is that? You can download all the charts for my video tonight and have them on your computer for tomorrow. Grab your free pass. Please don't forget to grab your free pass to come out and join me as a guest in our trade room. If you're not a member here, and you're wondering all the commotions about, grab your free pass in the upper right-hand corner. And don't forget, you can join the trial membership. You can learn more about what it means to be a member. You can read our frequently asked questions on the right-hand side of the website. And remember, I'm always here to help you guys out 24/7, 365, if you have any questions along the way. Hope you guys had a great weekend out there. Boy, it feels good to be a trader right about now. Best time of the year. Lots of volatility. Welcome back. Welcome back to the fall here. Now, tomorrow is Tuesday, September the 27th. And of course, didn't she just speak? It seems like she's speaking every week these days, right? But this, of course, being the semi-annual testimony in front of the House Finance Committee. That's right. It was FOMC last week, right? So, of course, we can expect a little bit more of that on, it's going to be Wednesday. And then, where is it? And Thursday, right? There you go. So it'll be Wednesday and Thursday this week. Here we got Yellen. And usually when Yellen is on the schedule, usually we get about a half day. We'll talk more about that tomorrow, right? Because that's not going to affect us too badly here in tomorrow's session. We got some light news from the BOJ. You know, that may have a little bit of an impact going into London session tonight, 7:50 p.m. Eastern time. Be aware of that if you're trading Asia or early London. Get some minor news. Not a lot of big news here. We get the BOJ tonight at 7:50 p.m. And, you know, really all these, you know, we get a Case-Shiller. We get a consumer confidence. They're really minor news reports tomorrow. You know, in fact, I would imagine tomorrow's big headlines are whatever crazy things come out of the mouths of the candidates that are going to be debating in only a few hours' time from now as I record this video. I'm sure you'll have your popcorn in hand, all right? I know I will. So tomorrow we may have just nothing more than kind of a reactionary Tuesday. No major news in the calendar. Wednesday is when we, of course, have Yellen now cracking into this week here, which means tomorrow's a full day. Wednesday is going to be a half day. Thursday potentially as well. And, of course, Friday is always a Friday. So that means today and tomorrow really are going to be the big two days of this week. And then we go into the end of the month, right? And, of course, we'll talk more about that as we go into the newsletter tomorrow. Because tomorrow we'll really start feeling on Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, we'll really start feeling the impacts of the end of the month. Not to worry, though. Tomorrow we're expecting to see another great day like we had today in our trade room. Let's jump right in. We got crude, S&P, gold, and maybe a little bit of the euro here before we finish up tonight. Crude is bearish and trying to finish a move back down to the battle zone with the potential of going sideways tomorrow around this pesky previous month's closing price at $45.55. Sellers have control after a strong move off the highs, which tells the sellers to be looking for opportunities to sell retracements for a second leg down to new lows and possibly a retest of today's low. Buyers, on the other hand, have a tough job ahead of them because Not only do they have a really strong move off the high, and whenever we see a strong move in any direction, it usually gets followed up, at least for a retest of that low. So buyers have it tough, right? Big strong move off the high, and then look above you. You got the resistance trend line, you got the 4590 wedge, you get the double up at 4601. There's a lot of resistance here overhead, right? And so basically, the best option tomorrow for buyers will be if we can get either a trading range, right? And this, you won't hear this out of my mouth very often, but the best opportunity for the buyers tomorrow just might be a trading range around this previous month's close at 45.55, or they need to find a way back up above that falling resistance trend line, right, and get a successful breakout pullback, because after all, there is a gap that's just kind of, you know, kind of glaring at us there at those highs right now. So they missed the fill the gap here a couple times back at that 46.20. So really the big thing that stands out is exactly what we talked about today in our trade room, right? We opened up this morning. We had a nice, beautiful bull wedge. We were looking to buy the low of that wedge all morning today. It was a relatively easy job. Spike and channel wedge. There's a few different opportunities here on the way higher here. They got their wedge target. They got their double up target. They almost, I thought for a while there, they were going to run all the way to Friday's high, which is up there at 46.55. But then all of a sudden, right, we see this kind of brick here, the gap. They try once to get it. They try twice to get it. And then you can almost feel the buyers going, all right, boys, we're done here, and just giving up on it, right? And then this thing just kind of just collapses right back down. You can even see here the buyers tried to buy it low here, but at that point the damage had been done. Now we have a very strong move off the high. We have a resistance trend line coming down off the highs. That resistance trend line is really public enemy number one for the buyers right now. That's going to, in combination with the fact that we have the strong move off the high, it's going to keep people like me from wanting to buy this unless we can buy really low, right? So we don't have to buy into that resistance or buy it on the breakout pullback. So if I'm a buyer right now, here are a couple things you want to be thinking about. First of all, if it goes higher, breakout pullback, wouldn't that be lovely, right? Wouldn't that be lovely? That's a little bit of a pipe dream right now as we look right now, but that would be where the buyers would be looking if it does go higher. And their objective, of course, be back up to fill the gap and then, of course, up to, right, retest Friday's high at that 46.55. Another thing here for the buyers, like I said before, would be with this real strong move lower, right? We get another leg, okay? Then, of course, a seller failure, and then the buyers can then buy, right, off the battle zone, off the double down, off of the reversal line at 45.45. The one thing the buyers don't want to do right now, though, is buy into that resistance. So, you know, imagine for a moment here, the moving average comes down. Again, we'll talk about sellers in a moment here, right? But imagine now sellers hold, chop, 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 breakout, pull back, right? And that would be where the most reliable buying opportunities would come. Keep in mind, if we do end up all the way down into the battle zone, of course, being this 45.32 to 45.11, if we do end up being all the way down in that battle zone, then all of a sudden this is a bear market. So the seller failure is not going to be as reliable, right? This will be probably a 40-60, maybe even less than that. This will be the 60-40 trade. Remember, the difference between a professional trader and a retail trader oftentimes is just simply knowing the difference between a 40-60 trade and a 60-40 trade, right? So if it pulls back even further, becomes a bear market, which means just blindly buying that battle zone will be lower reliability than we really want to be. Okay, so the third opportunity here now, this is what may happen. You know, we get the prior month close, and we don't worry too much about a prior month close until the very end, right, the last few days of the current month. And that has a lot to do with larger traders who are defending positions or looking to see whether or not they're going to be in the green on their monthly hold. So we know right now that we have that 45.55. Now, there's a couple of these tonight. One of them is on the euro as well. We may end up just seeing the sellers hold, the buyers hold, the sellers hold, and this may end up going into a range. That's one very distinct possibility here with the overhead resistance, right, with the support below us. We may go into a range, and if we do go into a range, then, of course, the buyer is going to look for failures buying those lows. We're going to talk more about trading ranges on gold in just a moment. So you can apply what I say on gold, right, to a possible trading range here on the crude. I don't mean to overcomplicate that, but at least that will keep this video relatively short. So you can of course get on with your evening. So again, if you're a buyer right now, it's going to be a strong breakout pullback above. Keep your eye on that Friday high, right? It'll be a seller failure into holding the pullback, right, for the move back up, right? Or we go sideways, and of course we find the range, and the buyer's looking to buy the low of that range using seller failure. We'll talk more about that in a moment. What about the bears? Well, of course, the bears, they have definitely short-term control right now, very strong move. And with that strong move, we do expect them to double that move down. We do expect there to be, at the very least, a pullback and return back to the low. At the very most, we expect a measured move off of this high. I was tempted, you know, we can do this right now, but, you know, kind of measure that move down. This, of course, is very much speculation right now. But, you know, if we have a moving average here, right, we go up, come back down, right? There's your objective. Like I said before, sellers are ultimately trying to get down into that battle zone. They don't want to sell into the prior month close, right? They don't want to sell the 40, the 45, the 55. They don't want to sell the 45, 45. So really right now, stay away from selling into this area and focus on getting them shorts, right, off of that moving average. Or what would really be awesome would be a beautiful trap. Remember that resistance trend line overhead? Let's get this out of here real quick. Remember that resistance trend line overhead that we talked about? Well, of course, this is where you can anticipate now. If we get back above that moving average, buyers are probably going to miss that trend line, try to buy it, right? Bang their head against the wall there. And, of course, easy mistake to make if you're a buyer. Sellers, of course, can capitalize on that and sell into that failure. The hard part's going to be, though, if we do end up settling in around the 45, 45, 45, 40, right, this area right here. I'm going to want to really be careful here right now, not looking to get selling here until we get that breakout pullback. I want to look for that breakdown below that area of support. So if you're a seller, either get to it now, well, not now, but if you're a seller, though, look for that move off the resistance trend line, right, off the moving average back down, whether it's going to be a pullback setup or whether it's a failure setup, right? I don't see much of a trap here right now, because if it does go back to the highs, then you got to worry that resistance trend line now becomes support. And that's when, of course, buyers can sink their teeth into. So as long as we stay below this trend line, I think you're really looking good there, right, for a seller opportunity here, right? Pullbacks, failures. One thing I'm worried about, though, is just trying to sell into this area. I would much rather have you break down, pull back, hold, right, get below that area. Then, of course, you got a big target down there at 44, 43. For some reason, though, I would, again, you know, whenever we see this stuff, you know, you've got a big level there at 45, 55. You got resistance keeping the buyers in check. You got support keeping the sellers in check. This may end up just going sideways here. And if it does, buy low, sell high, focus on failures. We'll grab a look at that on gold in just a moment. Speaking of which, let's keep going here. S&P is bearish and trading at a major support level inside a bear wedge, which tells the sellers to be looking for traps and failures above the previous swing levels overhead, or run the risk trying to sell a new low with a small target down at the wedge at 33.5. Buyers, on the other hand, oh, you poor buyers, right? Got to see some real serious strength right now and then hold a pullback if they want to deter the sellers from selling into any move that comes off these lows. Whenever we see a move like this, right, this is, of course, a bear, call it a bear spike in channel, right? There's your bear spike in channel, right? That gives you a correction zone up here in this neck of the woods. I don't think a lot of folks are going to call this a bear spike in channel just because of the fact that we broke high and already retested low. I would call this a spike and wedge. Either way you slice it, it pretty much gives us the same idea right now, right? Everybody should be looking to the short side here until we see something different. Now, it's relatively easy. Right now, there are sellers here who do not want to sell at that triple down, right? Sellers are not going to want to sell low. If it goes lower, then all of a sudden the sellers run into the measured move. If it goes lower, then all of a sudden you have the wedge support there at 33.4. By the way, did you see what happened on crude today when they got to that wedge, right? Here's a wedge back on crude, sorry, right? Here's what happened on crude, right? Try to keep it going. It's relatively rare. Not that it can't happen tomorrow, but it is relatively rare when we get to a wedge target. You're usually going to need to see some sort of correction before we can get more. Because everybody's already in Crude's case, everyone was already in long. On the S&P's case, right, everyone's in short right now.